Comic books and video games go hand in hand like the USA and endless wars. Sure, you know all the video games based off of Marvel and DC comics, but every now and then the video game industry extends its digital hand to high-five a comic book property that's not enslaved by malevolent Marvel or dastardly DC. This is From Pixels to Panels, video games based off of independent comic books. Before we start, a disclaimer. The comics on this list went straight from independent comics obscurity to vivacious video game notoriety. So other independent comics who have movies or cartoons based off of them just don't count. You know, kind of like your vote in the last election? Kicking off our list, all the sad sacks in the 90s who opted for a Nintendo 64 instead of the far superior Sony PlayStation probably had a copy of Turok, Dinosaur Hunter, a first-person shooter developed by Iguana Entertainment and published by Acclaim for the Nintendo 64 and Microsoft Windows. It was released in 1997 in North America and Europe to great reviews and even better sales numbers, eventually leading to a sequel and a remake. The player assumes the control of Tal Set, aka Turok, a Native American time-traveling warrior. The mantle of Turok is passed down every generation to the eldest, or is it oldest, male. Each Turok is charged with protecting the barrier between Earth and the Lost Land, a primitive world where time has no meaning, just like the DMV. Where did they get this wacky idea? Well, straight from the Turok Dinosaur Hunter comic books, stupid. Or at least one of them. You see, Turok has been around much longer than his video game premiere. In fact, Turok's first appearance was 4-Color Comics number 596, all the way back in December 1st, 1954, a time when men were men and a good dino was a dead dino. Back then, Turok was known as Son of Stone and was created by artist Rex Maxon, who wins the award for manliest name ever, and writer Gaylord Dubois, who wins the award for name that sounds most like a corrupt New Orleans district attorney. As you can see, Turok has been around for a while, and has had multiple writers and artists and publishers, but it wasn't until Acclaim purchased Valiant Comics in 1994 that led to the Dinosaur Hunter's very own video game exclusive for the Nintendo 64. Now, they may have stopped making Turok video games, but the Dino Hunt continues, thanks to Dynamite Publishing, who is still making Turok comics to this day. One thing I don't understand is why they didn't tell me about Turok in history class. Stupid public schools, they filled my head with useless junk. Speaking of useless junk, Scud, the Disposable Assassin, made his video game premiere on the Sega Saturn, published by Segasoft. Scud was released on February 28th in 1997 in North America only because the rest of the world knew it sucked and the mixed reviews basically proved it. In fact, the only thing really memorable about Scud is the fact that you can play run and gun or with a light gun. And yes, since it's on this list, Scud is indeed based off of a comic book. A super indie comic, in fact, published from 1994 to 1998. And then again in 2008 by Fireman Press and then Image Comics. Scud was created by writer-artist Rob Schrab, and the storyline revolves around Scud, a Heartbreaker series robotic assassin that's purchased from a vending machine. Scud discovers if he completes his first job, he will self-destruct. So he begins accepting work as a hitman so he can keep his first mark alive. Scud is a bizarre and hilarious comic that really is of its era. Or is it era? The go-go 90s. Read a few issues with your favorite grunge band playing in the background while drinking a Surge, but skip the game. Well, that game sucks so bad, I feel like I'm shrouded in darkness. Speaking of darkness, The Darkness is a terrible throwback band from the early 2000s. In fact, they make my dark thoughts even darker. But we're not here to talk about the band or my thoughts. We're here to talk about a different darkness. The Darkness, a first-person shooter video game developed by Starbreeze Studios and published by 2K Games for the PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. The game was released in 2007 in North America and Europe to great reviews and over a million in sales. In the game, you take control of mafia hitman Jackie Estacado. Domo arigato, Jackie Estacado. With a name like that, it's really your only job option. Jackie, on his 21st birthday, became the bearer of the Darkness, an elemental force that allows access to an otherworldly dimension and control over the demons who dwell there. In other words, he's allowed to legally drink alcohol. The game faithfully follows the comic The Darkness, published by Top Cow Productions. The series was created by Mark Silvestri, Garth Ennis, and David Wall. All three of them worked on the comic, but it has had multiple artists and writers. The Darkness's first appearance was Witchblade number 10 back in November 1996. The Darkness series was then launched later that year and went on in one form or another all the way till 2013. Whether it's a video game or a comic book, people just can't get enough of the cold embrace of the Darkness. Alright, let's roll back the clock again to a simpler time and game with Zen, Intergalactic Ninja, a side-scrolling platforming beat-em-up, published by Konami and released for the NES on March 7th, 1993. In it, you play as Zen, a militant environmentalist ninja. He has been assigned by a group of green, pointy-headed aliens to come to Earth and stop environmental pollution by any means necessary. Eventually, he will have to find the big polluter, aka the Exxon Corporation. I mean, in the game, it's known as Lord Contaminus. The gameplay consists of side-scrolling, isometric 3D scrolling action. Zen can run, jump, slice with his stick, or use power-ups as the game requires. As for the Zen comic, Zen made his first appearance in Zen Intergalactic Ninja number 1, published by Zen Comics Publishing back in 1987. Zen was created by writer Stephen L. Stern and artist Dan Cote, but has had numerous artists and publishers over the years. The first Zen Comics plot is similar to the game with an environmental message. Wonder if he ever hung out with Captain Planet. But over time, much of Zen took place away from Earth in outer space, where Zen uses his skills as a mercenary, hiring himself out to the highest bidder. Which really isn't all that Zen, if you think about it. Oh well, it was the 90s. Everyone was a mercenary back then. We may never see another Zen game again, but the saga still continues in comic book form even to this day, thanks to First Devil's Due Publishing. So check it out. Let he who is without Zen cast the first stone. So, from one martial artist to the next, it's time for Samurai Warrior, The Battles of Yusaki Yojimbo. It's a computer game released for the Commodore 64, ZX Spectrum, and Amstrad CPC platforms in 1988 by the now-defunct label Firebird. I guess they went down in flames. The game was released in the United States under the title Yusagi Yojimbo as part of the Thunder Mountain Action Pack Volume 1. The game is a side-scrolling adventure where Miyamoto Yusaki has to defeat opponents in sword fights and also have encounters with other anthropomorphic animal characters. Yusaki is often attacked by bandits and enemy ninja. These opponents frequently disguise themselves as harmless peasants, villagers, or priests. You hear that? Never trust a priest. He's probably a ninja. For its time, the game was received well, and of course is based on a comic titled Yusaki Yojimbo, which translates to Rabbit Bodyguard. There you go, kid. You just learned some Japanese. Now go get me some sushi. Written, drawn, and created by Triple Threat Stan Sakai, Yusaki Yojimbo first appeared in Albedo Anthropomorphics number 2, published by Thoughts and Images in November 1984, back when men were men and rabbits were samurais. God darn it. This was the first of many publishers, as Yusagi proved quite popular. In fact, Yusagi was named the 31st greatest comic book character by Empire Magazine. The book is set primarily at the beginning of the Edo period of Japanese history. The main character is a rabbit ronin, Miyamoto Yusagi. Yusagi wanders the land, occasionally selling his services as a bodyguard. The only question left is who would win in a fight, Zen Intergalactic Ninja or Yusaki Yojimbo? This is Ben from Pixels to Panels, video games based on independent comics. See, you don't have to be a corporate sellout to have success. Did I miss anyone? I know for a fact I did. Let me know who else you want to hear about. And finally, do the most heroic thing a human being can do these days and subscribe. And never forget, the power is yours!